think it's Tuesday. Crazy.
Sectioned off, sir. Please step back.
Agent Norman Jaden, FBI.
You got a badge or something, Mr. Jaden?
Yeah. Yeah, of course.
Check. You can pass.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Blake. Is he around?
I saw him arrive earlier. He's here somewhere.
Thanks.
Man, teleporter.
Video memo recording, Agent 47023, Norman Jaden, Tuesday, October 4th, 2011. Time is 8:14 a.m.
Talk to him first.
Lieutenant Blake, I'm Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI. I went by your office this morning. They told me to be here.
Now, if you're looking for rain, dead bodies, and highways, you come to the right place. Mike, will you tell that asshole with the bulldozer to stop for 5 minutes? I can't hear myself think here.
Right away, Lieutenant.
Well, are you coming, Jaden?
So, what happened?
Some guy taking his dog for a piss found a body about 6 o'clock this morning. We don't know much more right now. Based on what we've seen, looks like the work of the origami killer.
Has the body been identified?
No, not yet. We should know more later today. Any news on the coroner?
He's on his way, Lieutenant.
We've been waiting for an hour, for fuck's sake.
Yeah, I've been playing for an hour.
There are a lot of people
sake,
on the crime scene. Aren't you afraid your men might destroy some clues?
You don't find proof sitting behind a desk. We're not in the habit of trampling things into the ground, even if we're not in the FBI.
No. No, of course not. That's not what I meant. Listen, you look busy. Do you mind if I have a look around?
Be my guest. Hey, Jaden. Come and see me if you find anything, okay? We're on the same team now.
Harry, comment. The victim is lying on his back. No visible signs of violence.
Oh, shit, no. Why do that? Bruh, go back.
and the orchid was placed on the victim's chest. A small origami figure in the right hand. Fingers were probably closed after the time of death. The victim is Jeremy Bowles, declared missing 5 days ago. See reference file. Superficial wound on the right thigh. Blood analysis suggests it could be post-mortem. Probably a scratch that occurred when the body was being moved. The blood report indicates an advanced and long-lasting state of exhaustion. His face is covered with mud, like the other victims.
That's it, right?
Harry, comment. Sample of no interest. Comes to one of the policemen present on the wasteland.
Oh. Oh, here we go.
Harry, come in. Orchid pollen detected. Probably from the flower left on the body. Harry, come in. Pollen particles disappear in the tall grass. It's probably the end of the trail.
Oh, I still scan. That's right.
Footprints continue just after the pollen trail. There's a good chance that they're the killers.
There you go. Okay.
Harry, comment. Traces of blood on the railroad track. Analysis confirms it comes from the victim. Harry Conant, the traces of blood on the fence behind the railroad line. It comes from the victim. The killer came this way with the body and probably grazed it on his way through the fence.
Man, dirty as shit now.
There's a good chance that they're the killers. On the side of the road behind the railroad line. It may be the killer's car. I think I've seen all there is to see.
Yep, that's it. Yeah, I did not want to do that. So I can take this off. go back. That's pretty fun. Can I just go back to the car now?
I'm heading back to the office. You staying?
No, I'm leaving.
No, I've seen enough. I'm leaving too.
Why can't I go back? Well, if I have to wait for him. One part of nerd, and then we got another one called FBI investigator. FBI investigator. Butterfly?
Don't think, Ethan. Give me the first idea that pops into your head.
Oh, well. Missed that choice. Butterfly?
Butterfly.
Wolf?
A wolf's head.
Blades?
Sharp blades.
Death?
Death.
Terror.
Death.
You might be worried about everything.
I have the results of your MRI scans. Everything seems to be normal. There is no physical damage from the accident. However, I am worried about your psychological condition.
Do I even need to say?
I know it's not easy, but you've got to start over, Ethan. You're not responsible for what happened.
It's my fault Jason is dead. He'd still be alive if I'd been looking out for him.
Going to sleep.
It was an accident. Accidents happen every day. You can't blame yourself forever for your son's death.
That's me. That's me.
How
right
is
there.
Shaun?
I know he's really unhappy. He just can't understand why.
It's like no trophy for this
unable
scene,
to
so.
Love him.
And what about you, Ethan? What do you feel?
How do I feel? Let me see. Dead, depressed.
I no longer want to live.
Huh?
I have no reason to continue.
Huh?
Not even for your son, Shaun.
I couldn't save Jason. Shaun doesn't need a father like me.
Is there something else you wanted to tell me, Ethan?
Blackouts, I guess.
I sometimes have these blackouts.
This might be too extended. I should have just said nothing.
I don't know what I'm doing. I recover consciousness sometime later. But I'm someplace else. And I have no idea how I got there. Do you think this could be related to the accident?
You suffered a massive concussion and were in a coma for 6 months. We really don't know what effect a shock like that can have on the brain.
Was that from the car?
That's the end of this session. We'll continue this conversation next week.
So I never understood that. The place
you were lucky,
Ego.
Ethan. It's very rare to survive such a traumatic accident.
I don't exactly feel lucky, Doctor.
No, you're definitely not going to later on, I can tell you that. Alright, here we go. The parkway.
Aren't you gonna go play with the other kids?
I don't feel like it.
Well, can I just get up and ask? Let me see.
I haven't been on a seesaw in a long time. What do you think?
Yeah!
So we do that. Oh, I'm supposed to be on it?
Come on, Dad, make me fly!
They just automatically know it. Wee. 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 It looks like that, because he's doing all the work to push him up. I wish I got a girl that was like really, really strong and just pushed me off the seesaw just like that. I'm just a little ass kid and having fun. Oh my god, it's getting here faster. Do you ring around the rosy? No, I'm not doing that. We're doing this. We can't do this one, okay. We gotta do something before something activates. I'm scared. Can we play this? Merry-go-round. Right.
What about that merry-go-round? I bet I can push you so fast you won't be able to stay on it.
Great!
What the hell?
Go on, Dad, as fast as you can. Faster! Faster! Come on!
Are we still doing it?
Faster!
Oh my god, it's about to make me dizzy. I should not pick this. Second
Whoa.
One, and then now we gotta buy him candy.
My head is spinning.
Good training for astronauts, though.
Hey, you wanna eat some nerds?
I'd like a packet of strawberry flavored chewies, please. Thanks. Hey, I got you some chewies.
I hate strawberry.
Damn.
Thanks. It was nice of you anyway.
Can I get chocolate instead? Can I get chocolate instead? No, I guess not. It says leave. Where are you going? Let's do something else. Ooh. Can we take you here? I'm gonna extend my time on this. Unless something activates. No, that's it. I guess, okay. Alright, where you at? I guess we can't do anything else.
Looks like rain's coming. I think we better go.
Okay.
What the hell?
You know, sometimes I remember before. I mean, when Jason was still here. Sometimes I wish everything could just be the way it was before.
Me too, Shaun. Me too.
Where are we going? Trying to do a merry-go-round? Why you stop?
Hey, Dad, can I have a ride on the carousel?
Yeah, there we
can
go.
Can I?
Oh, that's right. Okay.
Sure. Go pick a horse and get on. I'll get a ticket.
What the hell? You'll talk to him for the ticket? Oh, bro.
One, please.
That's a dollar.
All right, where you at? Oh shit. That's what happens when I don't pay attention. Fuck that, let me just go upstairs. There you go. Because of that truck. Good friends. Okay, so now I gotta answer like three things correctly. I guess I'm just chilling. Are we actually doing this right now? Finally, goddamn.
I'm off, Charlene. I'll look at the reports later. Oh, cancel all appointments for this afternoon.
Okay. Oh, Captain, Agent Norman Jaden from the FBI is here.
Sup?
Jaden, of course. We've been expecting you.
Damn,
I'm
no
in a
control.
Bit of a hurry. Do you mind tagging along? We can talk as we walk.
Yeah, of course.
I wanted to introduce myself before getting started,
but perhaps there's a better time.
No, now it's fine. I just have to get to the press conference. We have them every day now. Believe me, it's not always easy finding something to tell them. Fortunately, today we have some news. Have you met Lieutenant Blake yet?
Yeah, we met this morning.
He has his own methods, but he's a good cop. I'm sure you'll get them well together. Do you know how to tie a knot in a necktie?
I guess.
To be frank with you, I could have done without the FBI on this one, but the press are all over us. This origami killer case crept up on us, and it's fast becoming a national concern. There are hundreds of killers in this country, but what do you know? This guy is exotic. He leaves flowers and origami figures. Work that one out.
Oh, damn, complicated.
And we suddenly become the center of the universe.
I'm here to arrest a serial killer. With all due respect, sir, the rest of it, it's none of my business.
Oh. Of course.
Awkward as shit.
All I'm asking is that you make progress, and fast. The press want a perpetrator, and we're gonna have to serve him up on a silver platter. Not bad. Oh, go see Charlene. She'll show you to your office. Yeah, check in on the press conference if you're interested. It'll give you an idea of the political climate around here.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to the club, Jaden.
I forgot where it was. Over here. Was it over here? No. God damn it, I forgot where the fuck it was. Oh my god, it's gonna take some time. Interrogation room. Um
I guess find an origami killer.
I don't think I'm supposed to be here yet.
No. Not trying to look. God damn, where the fuck was it? Okay, I think he's over here. No, there's people over here. Can I just go in there and do it?
For the moment, the killer may think he's invulnerable, but in the end, he'll make a mistake and we'll be there to arrest him. Yes?
Oh my gosh. Did
the killer leave any written evidence? Perhaps a ransom note explaining his
action? I forgot where to go. How's it gonna take some time? Man, I already messed up one trophy. Now I'm messing up where to fucking go. God damn it. Okay, what's he saying? I have to talk to Blake.
I should get Perry's assistant to show me my office. I can't wait to get to work.
Hey, what the fuck? Who the fuck is that? No.
Nice watch.
Oh, it's the present we offer to our new lieutenants. We bought the same model each year for the past 20 years for each promotion. It optimizes everybody's time, and it's the kind of thing that always goes down well. You can contribute to our fund if you like. We're still a few dollars short.
Sure. I don't mean anything,
congratulate Larry on my behalf.
Bro.
I'll be sure to do that, sir.
It's a waste of fucking... Okay, hold on.
Captain Perry said you could show me to my office?
Yes, of course. Follow me.
Damn it. So where the fuck was it the whole time? Oh, god damn it. It was over there. Okay.
This is my office?
That's where I was told to take you. If you need anything, you know where to find me.
Okay, time to work.
God damn it. This is like an unnecessary scene, man. I'm pretty sure I'm supposed to go somewhere to get this over with, because I'm not
Step
trying to do
one.
This.
Change the
like, or I guess I think this is part of this. Okay, fall. Whatever. Make it fall. Yeah, whatever. We can go that way. How you select? Okay. Do I really want to do all this right now?
The killer's car is probably a Chevrolet Malibu 83. No prints or specific clues. Nothing much to go on. common species. That doesn't help much.
Can I not do this? Okay, I'm trying to get out. Hold on, let me actually leave. How you leave? Well, I guess I'm stuck doing this.
Eight victims in the last 3 years. All boys, aged between 9 and 13.
Because I have to do all this.
No signs of violence. The victims disappear from public places in broad daylight. No one notices anything.
Mm-mm.
Bodies are found 3 to 5 days later.
Mm-hmm.
Drowned.
Mm.
In rainwater.
Mm. That explained the mud in the face. Oh, oops.
Always the same ritual. An origami in the hand, an orchid on the chest. The victims have always been dead for less than 6 hours when they were found, which means they remained alive for several days before being drowned.
Mm-hmm. And you know what they do?
Over 3,500 people questioned. Over 100 suspects interrogated. Not a single lead to go on.
That's crazy. Alright, what else I need to look? Oh, there we go. Alright, now I can go proc. Oh, shit. Oh, no. Oh, no.
Here we go again. I better go wash my face. I need to take some.
I'm gonna faint
if I resist. It's all right. I know I can make it. I know I can make it.
I don't know where the bathroom is. I'm taking it. I'll be alright. Alright, here we go. This is the part where trophy kicks in now. Yep, there he is.
This is Lieutenant Blake, Mr. Marsh. Could you please tell him what happened?
It was this afternoon. I went to the park with my son, Shaun. We played together for a while, and then he wanted to go on the carousel, so I put him on one of the wooden horses, and when I turned back, Shaun had disappeared.
Exactly what time did you arrive at the park? Try to remember exactly, Mr. Marsh.
There you
Every
go.
Detail can be important.
So 4:15.
It must have been about... 4:15. Yeah, that's it, 4:15. I remember exactly, because I looked at the clock in the park
Jacket
when we arrived.
Beige.
What was your son wearing when he disappeared?
He was wearing a coat.
So, X.
A beige coat. And a pair of pants.
And the pants were... Oh, shit, I can't see. Okay, X again.
Green
oh,
pants.
Damn.
How could Shaun have disappeared without
They're
you
all
even
X.
noticing? Weren't you right by the carousel?
I can't remember.
I can't remember exactly. It all happened so fast.
You say you took your son to the park after school. But you didn't report him missing until 8:15. Why did it take you so long to contact the police?
Because you're looking for him. Yeah, he's searching.
I searched the whole neighborhood for him. I thought he couldn't have gone far.
All right. That's all the questions I have for now. You're free to go, Mr. Mars. We'll continue to look for Shaun overnight. We'll contact you if we have any more questions.
Okay.
Do you think the origami killer...
Listen, your son's probably just run off and he'll turn up in a couple of hours.
But what if it is the origami killer?
Well, then we have about 4 days to find him alive.
Oh, she back.
Did they find something?
No, nothing yet, but they're gonna keep looking through the night.
Do they think it's the origami killer?
It's still too early to say, but it is a possibility.
What happened, Ethan? How could you lose Shaun like that? You should never have taken your eyes off him.
I gotta check the trip, though.
How hard is it to keep your eye on a child in the park? Why did you leave him, Ethan? Why? Wasn't it enough losing Jason? I'm sorry. It's not what I meant to say.
I'm missing to him. Rest in peace. It's like now. To remember. Okay. Alright, so this is the start of perfect crime. So I gotta make sure he dies.
Evening.
Good evening to you, sir. Can I help you, sir?
Well, I hope so. My name's Scott Shelby. I'm a private detective. I'm investigating the case of the origami killer. I'd like to ask you a few questions.
My son is dead, Mr. Shelby. I have nothing more to say.
I'll leave my card, in case you change your mind.
Sure.
Don't bother, Mr. Shelby. There really is no point.
Okay.
Oh, do you sell inhalers? I'm all out, and at least I won't go away completely empty-handed.
In the back of the store, to the right.
Change my mind telling all the stories. I don't want to hear all your shit. You're like, I don't care anymore. Let me just manage the store. But pretty much that's all you're trying to say. Oh shit. Alright. Now.
Good evening, sir.
You just chill.
Are you looking for something in particular?
Give me what you got in the register. Don't fucking try anything. Open the register, you dumb fuck. Put the money on the counter. Shit, are you deaf or what? Are you gonna open that fucking register or not?
No.
No, sir.
No.
You do not have the right to steal that money from me.
Uh-uh.
I have worked very hard to earn it. You cannot have it.
What did you say? You're out of your fucking mind, man. You don't get it, do you? I'm gonna put a fucking bullet right between your eyes if you don't do what I say now!
You shall not be robbing my register, sir. That money is mine. I ask you now to leave before it is too late.
Christ! Goddamn idiot! Open the register! Don't make me fucking kill you!
No. No.
No, sir.
No.
That I cannot do!
I can't, nope. I have
don't
a gun right
man.
Here.
I ain't joking.
Let me pick it up.
I swear to God, man, I'll blow your fucking brains out!
Good.
The goddamn thing is locked.
No shit. You gotta make them open it.
Swear to God, man, I'm gonna blow your fucking brains out. One!
It's almost nothing in the register.
Don't do it.
You wouldn't kill a man for a few dollars.
Two!
It is not right, sir. It is not right.
Three!
Mm.
Shit. Oh, shit.
Oh, shit. He actually did it. Oh, shit. No. Why you gotta do that, man? Rest in peace. Man, run. Can I just leave the store? Shit.
I wish I had lived long enough to look into the eyes of the man who killed my race. Too much anger here.
I don't blame you. It's just too much anger here, too. Rest in peace. I'm gonna get the origami killer. I swear to God. I'm gonna get him. You'll see.